What are you doing? Attacking me. Mister? Fuck, 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 fuck! Just too many of them! You're doing nothing. Where's the third guy? Oh, pump action. Yeah, I want the pump action. What? Like that? Bam. Bam. Oh shit! Where are they all coming from? Shit, that's the wrong one. But I have enough, so maybe it's okay. Where are they? Can't see what the fuck I'm shooting. What? Where did you come from? Shit. I think I won. Yeah, I got the achievement. Children of the Elder God. What was it for? Not dropping to a low health state, yeah, got that. That's all I wanted. Okay. Collected everything up. Okay, now we can go.
Hey, Al! This way to the farm!
Yes, I'm looking for some manuscript pages. We have already found and thermos cans. But if I found the page, I probably looked around for thermos cans too. Thermos. No. I see a blinking button. Oh, and I see my cutout.
No reason to worry. Your cutout's good as new, right where I left it. I'll come back for it once we have the place secure.
Yeah, that's been my biggest worry all this time.
Mine too.
We need to get this thing moved out of the way.
This is as far as I got before they ambushed me.
Let's see what we can find. Any secrets? There's a blinking light. There's a probably closed gate. Yep. So we can't get there. There's another manuscript page we've already found. And we can't go over there, so we have to get up here. Oh shit, and we gotta jump. Are you ready, Alan? Good job, dude.
Hey, I think Alan Wake here has something to say. What's that, Al?
Oh, I'm Alan Wake. I'm always right about everything. And if I don't get my way, I'll sulk all day long. I'm always intense and moody. It makes me very attractive and mysterious. Right now, I'm just standing here. Best friend Barry to carry me. That's okay. I could just take him for granted.
I think I see what you did there.
Yeah, it was pretty good.
You want me to do my imitation of Barry Wheeler? No? Thought so.
Why on earth is the button up here? It makes no sense. Ouch. Okay, I've jumped lower heights and got hurt. What the fuck, game?
Wow! You look at that thing, Al! They really went all out with this Viking crap, didn't they? Look at all this stuff! They must have done okay for themselves, so how come I never heard of these guys before?
And this from the guy who learned about Ozzy Osbourne through reality TV?
Good old Ozzy. Let's... Oh, there's a... Oh, there's a TV, can I? Yes. Light springs? Yes!
Sleep. We all spend
oh, shut up!
Spring.
Oh, it's talking about it.
Hey, remember when I got you that gig? Your first real writing job. What got you started? Was this one of your episodes?
In night space. Tonight's episode. The Dream of Dreams.
Eh, that's by someone else.
We join Mr. Jones as he explores the endless dreamscape, only to be brought to a sudden stop by a decidedly mundane situation.
Jones, right? Listen, we're gonna have to wait until His Highness over there is good and ready.
Oh, wow. Who's that?
You don't know him? What are you, new? He's the guy dreaming us. Well, not just us. He dreams everything. All of this.
But wait, no. I'm the one who's dreaming. I'm asleep. Isn't this my dream?
Oh, yeah. Sure. Get real, pal. You're just another dream. I'm a dream. You're a dream. Weirdo in the diving suit is a dream, and the girl made of smiles and sunshine is definitely a dream.
But I'm pretty sure I'm dreaming this.
Well, maybe you're a really confused dream. What am I, a shrink? All I know is I'm going with the smart guys, and they say that's the guy doing the dreaming. Right there.
I don't know what that means.
It means we keep him happy. No sudden falls. We make sure he has his clothes on when he goes out in public. No Joe chases where the monster is nipping at his heels and he runs like crazy, but his legs don't seem to get him anywhere. None of that. Because if he wakes up in a cold sweat... Yeah, precisely. So we wait till he wants to move on. Keep things nice and calm.
Hey, something's happening here.
Yeah? What's that?
What? Can't you hear that? Oh, God, help us. It's an alarm clock. Oh, it's you, isn't it? Please, man, I got a wife and kids. Please don't wake...
Not even the outro? What the fuck is going on?
The Viking boat looked imposing, almost like a battering ram.
Battering ram? It died. No, it don't die. Dun, 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 dun. Holy shit. The Old Gods of Asgard, the 1975 Ragnarok Tour. Be awed by celestial wrath and fury. Wow. Okay, there's bad guys out there again. Who would have thought? There's a bad guy up there. Die. Thank you. Where's the other guy? There's one. There's one behind. I dodged something I didn't see. Oh shit, he takes three. I dodged that. Shit. Whoo. Wee. Screw you guys. I'm going home. That's scaring me. I don't want to play a horror game. How do I get down there? Barry? What are you? Oh, not one of those guys again. Bye.
I think we can make it through here, Al.
Please, no, stop running. You're only making this harder for yourself. Now he's stuck in the corner. Good job, dude. Your mama would be proud. Okay. Yeah, but there are electrical wires. I don't want to get shocked. But I guess I have to walk through. Any secrets we've missed? Nope. I don't think so. Oh, there's a lot of them. Come here, car. Oh shit. Who's attacking me? Oh shit, the wire! Shit, fuck. Yep, you died. Can I get healed somehow, please? No! No! Mm. Tried to run into the light. Well, the light just killed me. That stupid electrical thingy. What are you doing? Idiot. I'll take the fucking shotgun. Wait until it's reloaded. Flashlight, let it go. What are you attacking? You want some of this? You're still alive? What? What? Is the car gonna attack me? Apparently not. Yeah, Barry, you could have helped me. You have a flashlight too. Just point them. Point it at them. It would mean a lot.
Alive, I'm gonna start representing them. Yep, sell this stuff online, maybe get a reality show going, release a new single.
Good luck with that, pal.
Hey, you find us a way out of here, okay? I'm gonna take a closer look at this stuff. Be careful!
Ammunition. Ammunition. Why would you hide there? Is there more? There's another heavy duty flashlight. And a radio.
As you regular listeners know, I tend to work through the night, but I'm not the only one. Deputies Mulligan and Thornton are taking a couple of moments off their busy schedule to join me here in the studio. Boys, how busy are you now? Deerfest is almost here, isn't it? I bet that keeps you in business.
Pretty busy, yeah. Actually, Pat, we've been real busy with other stuff. Which concerns an ongoing investigation. We can't talk about that, Thornton.
I wasn't gonna say anything. I was just saying we got, you know, other irons to fry.
And how would you compare your workload to last year's? Things have seemed relatively peaceful to me, but people do tend to get a little wild this time of year.
Oh, it's wild, Pat. It's pretty wild. There's been all sorts of trouble this year. Vandalism, fighting, public disturbances. A lot of people gone missing, too.
It's pretty much the usual stuff, Pat. Just, you know, a lot more of it.
Now, is it just me, or does Deerfest get wilder every year? People seem to be more drunk, at least, or they start earlier and younger.
Oh, it's definitely not just you, Pat, but definitely, Pat. Hey, I'm talking here, Thornton. Oh, shoot, I lost my train of thought.
Not just me.
Oh, yeah, it's wilder, Pat, but actually most of the trouble seems to be coming from grown men. People who ought to know better, you know? The kids are doing fine this year.
Well, that's nice to hear, at least. Boys, I want to thank you for stopping by. I'll let you get back to your patrol.
Sure thing, Pat.
Yeah, sure thing, Pat.
Sure thing, Pat. Oh, look at here. Batteries. Okay.
I could see the building that had to be the Andersons' home on the other side of the field. Ooh. It wasn't far now. I wasn't worried about trusting the ramblings of two burned-out geriatric wrecks. They had the goods.
That's a nice harvester, or whatever they're called in English. Flashbangs. Bye, harvester. Oops. I said bye, harvester. Don't attack. What the fuck is it doing? Whee! I'm dead. Oh shit. I thought I had time until it attacks me. Take this. Move! Oh no, no more bad guys. Hey! I'm in the light, heal me. Oh shit, that's good. Well, you. What about you, mister? Oh, you want some of this? This? Can have it. More! I'm waiting. You wanna dance with me? You wanna dance? Whee! Nice moves! Whoa! Oh, what was that? Does it mean I can hurt you? Yes, it does! Come on, another one. Whoosh! That went right through me! Not like this shot, though. Ooh, nice! You wanna hold the ground? I wanna hold your face! Okay! Now we can get the stuff out of here. And now we get Mr. Wheeler. I'm still stuck in there. Look, now it hurts from there, but just a second ago I jumped from up there. Slow keys, okay. I have a bad feeling. Which sign of this one?
Al? Is that you out there, buddy?
Nope.
Yeah, it's me. Hang on.
Hey, let's go, man.
To work together to open this gate, Al. Looks pretty heavy.
Easy game.
Hey, I think that's the farm on the other side of the field. We're almost there. This farm is a crazy place for crazy people.
We should feel right at home then.
Nothing to find.
Come on, one more gate. Let's do this thing.
Chill, Barry. All gods know the truth. What about the young gods? Okay. What's that? How do I get there? Why is it here? I've never been there. Oh, Barry, I thought you went inside already. Well, no pages, no coffee.
The lights are out. I guess we better check the fuse box. You know, this place looks kind of lived in. I thought the Andersons were in the booby hatch.
Booby hatch? Ooh, a guitar. A pickup. Oh. Didn't see it. What do we have here? Oh, there's this fuse.
Can you hear that, Al? Music?
Of course. We need to find where it's coming from. That's the message the Andersons talked about. That's the whole reason.
And the lady of the light gone mad with the love. Here.
Cynthia Weaver.
Right. Must be.
Fireworks. Nothing to find. We have a stage here. Okay, what was I? Yeah, I played record.
Find Cynthia Weaver. We'll stay here for the night and head back to town as soon as it gets light.
Hey, Al. Lots of hours before dawn. Might as well get some rest. And by rest, I mean drunk.
Come on, Barry. This is... Yeah. What the hell?
All those authors and their alcoholism.
I'm gonna stick by you, no matter what, ever, Al.
Sure, like a brother.
I'm a writer, goddammit.
Correct.
If I just wanted to, I could write 10 books a year. And they'd be the best books that year.
No, you couldn't.
That's right, I couldn't. But I could, because I'm a writer.
What? This stuff. I feel like my brain...
That's my favorite quote. Oh no, I couldn't. But I could.
And be a booze millionaire.
I just miss her, Barry. I just want her here with me.
I know, Al. I know.
Aww.
It's gonna be okay. We're gonna make it okay.
He's sleeping with open eyes. That's so freaking creepy. Same scene again. That's still a card. What the f... Get to the cabin. What? What am I?
Alice, I'm coming. It's all right. I'm coming.
It was a crazy drunken dream. And yet, it was more than that. It was the truth. A suppressed memory unearthed by the Andersons' moonshine. I was there, an out-of-body observer. This was the night Alice and I had arrived at Bright Falls, the night Alice had disappeared. I had a chance to find out what had happened. I remember being surprised Alice? To see the cabin Alice? Dark. Alice would have never turned the lights off. I remembered thinking, I caught a glimpse of her form underwater, sinking into the darkness. Beyond this lost memory, there was nothing. I had to follow the footsteps of my past self to find out what had happened that night. Diving after her was the last vague memory I had of that night. After that, the next thing I could remember was waking up behind the wheel of the crash car and finding the first pages of the manuscript. I couldn't find her in all that blackness. I must have thought she drowned.
Alice!
Jagger had Alice,
Alice,
and so she had me.
Alice!
I'd been easy prey.
Look at the cabin. Is there someone in the window?
Alice?
No.
Maybe she didn't drown after all. Maybe she's inside.
Alice!
Yes.
No, Alice. Alan, don't. She dead, bro.
The dark presence had touched me. She had dug her nails into my brain and used me. Oh. Made me her puppet.
And you like that.
She must be here somewhere. Maybe upstairs in the study.
Alice!
Yes, that's where she is. You can apologize.
Alice!
You'll laugh at the whole thing together and put it behind you.
Alice?
She's not here. You were foolish to think so. No, she's dead. She drowned.
Dun, dun, dun.
No, no, no!
It's your fault your wife is dead. You are guilty. All she wanted was to help you right. You killed her.
Ah!
Oh, hush. There's still hope. Cauldron Lake is a special place. Here, you have the power to change things. She wanted you to write. I will tell you what to do. You can write her back. The story will
what?
Come true, and
it's
all
blinking.
Will be well again.
Typewriter.
She had Alice, and the manuscript was the ransom for her.
Yes. I'll write. I'll fix it. I'll bring her back.
Oops.
No, I wrote it.
I remembered it all now. In the dark, I'd written for days, a week, almost a complete manuscript of a novel entitled Departure. Jagger had been my editor, whispering in my ear, making sure that the unfolding story would make her more and more powerful. I thought I was saving Alice. Even with the cobweb she put in my head, some part of me had been aware enough to write my escape into the story, to bring a light into the cabin to release me before I could finish, to interrupt the horror story before the ending, where darkness consumed everything and everyone. Zane was weak and far away, but I had written him into the story, and his light had been enough to set me free.
It isn't here now. I'm here because it was written. I brought the light to set you free. You must hurry. We'll know I'm here. It will be back soon. She stole the skin of my armor a long time ago. She looks so old.
I had woken up, confused and groggy, my mind consumed by darkness and fear. All I could do was to escape. The week spent in the cabin had taken its toll. I was barely conscious and fading fast.
You're in no condition to drive, dude.
Thrown him even deeper into whatever dark place he now haunted. But he had managed to weaken the dark presence, kept me safe that night.
Idiot.
I wrote it. It's my fault.
That's right, James Joyce. It's your fault, and you're gonna pay for it.
Oh, the best song in the game. And we're gonna listen to all of it.
There's an altar wrought with mystery upon the poet and his muse.